Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In this program of the beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are going to speak now about his attribute al-Ghaffar and then al-Qahhar. Al-Ghaffar, the one who forgives a lot. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Taha, وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ لِمَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا ثُمَّ اهْتَدَى. And I am the forgiver for that person who does tawbah, who got iman, who does good deeds, and then he is guided. So the word ghaffar is used here, and we know that there are two more words, and they are also the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ghafir and ghafoor. And inshallah we are going to speak about them later as well. But here, let me say that the word ghafir, the one who forgives, ghafoor, which is also an excessive mode in Arabic language, who forgives a lot, and ghaffar, also another form of excessive mode in Arabic, who forgives a lot. They are mentioned here in comparison to these three attributes of the man. That is zalim and zaloom and dhallam. Because the man is declared zalim, فَمِنْهُمْ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ, that in this ummah there would be people who are doing injustice to themselves. So the word zalim is used. Zaloom is used. إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا, that the man was zaloomًا jahul. He was unjust and he was ignorant. And the word zallam is also used. So in comparison, we can say that if the man is zalim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafir. If the man is zaloom, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafoor. If the man is zallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghaffar. This is how three attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala facing three characters of the man. And that is a saying which is taken from Ar-Razi, the famous Mufassir of Al-Quran. Here, let me clarify another point. In this ayah, وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِذَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ, your Rabb is not a great unjust to the people. Some people would say that if you are negating the lam, does it mean that he is zalim? Because you are just saying, وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ, your Rabb is not zalam, yani doing injustice a lot to the people. You are just negating his being as zalam. So it means he could be zalim. For example, when you negate about a person and you say that he is not allam, that he got not great knowledge, but it does not mean that you are negating that he is a alim. He is a alim, but he is not allam. So that is the point which we want to bring into your notice, that some people may ask this question. So the answer to this question is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has negated zalam from himself, why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not zalim, he is not unjust. That is even for one single person. He is not zalim, but looking at the great number of the people, the word zalam is used, that he is not zalam, meaning he is not zalim for each one of them. This is how we can understand this word, and then there would be no question left. Coming back to Al-Ghaffar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives a lot. But for that forgiveness, he also demands from the people to repent. That is the ayah of Surah Taha, وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ لِمَنْ تَابَ, I forgive for the person who repent. And repentance should be done just after committing the sin. You know, you must not wait a lot. You have to ask the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you turn back to the right path immediately. And this is the ayah of Surah An-Nisa, which says, إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ بِجَهَالَةٍ ثم يتوبون من قريب فأولئك يتوب الله عليهم وكان الله عليما حكيما. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the tawbah from those people who do sins, who commit sins out of ignorance. ثُمَّ يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ, and then they repent immediately. Yani after the sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turns back upon them. So that is the condition that a person, when he commits a sin, immediately after it, he should realize that he has done something bad, so he repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepting his repentance. For the repentance, there are three vital conditions. First of all, that a person should regret that he has done something wrong. That is very important. And secondly, he should have a resolution of the mind not to do that thing once again. And the third thing, that he should have a good intention not to do that sin once again. So you can say correction of your intention, tashihun niyya, and then the regret, showing regret upon what we have done. And the third thing, a resolution of the mind that you are not going to repeat that sin once again. So if these conditions are met, then your repentance is acceptable. There is a fourth condition. If you are responsible for hurting someone, for taking someone's money, then ask forgiveness from him as well, because you have hurt him, you have slandered him, you have backbitten him. Ask his forgiveness. Or if you have taken his money, his property, any of his things, then return it back to him. Then your repentance would be complete. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also has promised a lot of a blessing in this world out of istighfar, when you seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, one of the saying of the Prophet, مَنْ لَزِمَ الْإِسْتِغْفَارَ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ مِنْ كُلِّ هَمٍ فَرَجًا وَمِنْ كُلِّ ضِيقٍ مَخْرَجًا وَرَزَقَهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. The person who says a lot of istighfar, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a way out for him from each and every worry, and also a way out from each difficulty and trouble, and he is going to sustain him from a quarter he could not expect. Now let us move to the other attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is Al-Qahhar, the dominant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is victorious and dominant in a way that he can do anything he wills. No one is going to stop him or to be an obstacle towards him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is dominant. His will is going to conquer. No person can frustrate him. The person who is pleased with him, he will remain in that player until he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the person who is not pleased with Allah, he would remain in that anger until he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we must not think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take vengeance, which is one of the impression of Al-Qahhar, that he is dominant, he is powerful, he can take the vengeance. Yes, he takes the vengeance if there is a reason for that. If you have done something to displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or if you have inflicted an injustice to someone else, a person against another person, an individual against another individual, a nation against another nation, then of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he comes to take vengeance, nobody can stop him. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَأَهْلَكْنَاهُمْ بِذُنُوبِهِمْ. We have destroyed them because of their sins. فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ. Every one of these nations, we have taken them because of his dhamb, because of his sin. This word Al-Qahhar is mentioned 6 times in Al-Quran. Let us take some of these ayat as the time allows. For example, Yusuf alayhi salam, when he was in the prison and he was giving a piece of admonition to his inmates. He said, Ya sahib ayyusidin, arbabun mutafarriquna khayrun amillahul wahidul qahhar. Oh, my two inmates of the prison, tell me, so many gods scattered, different, are they better? Are just one Allah who is dominant, whose will is dominant? And then the ayah of Surah Ar-Ra'd, قُلِ اللَّهُ خَالِقُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَحَّارِ. Say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of everything, and He is one, He is dominant. And the ayah of Surah Ibrahim, يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَحَّارِ. The day, that is the day of the judgment, when this earth is going to be changed with another earth, heavens to be changed with other heavens, and all the people would be exposing themselves, would be exposed to Allah, Al-Wahid Al-Qahhar, who is one, who is dominant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is dominant so that the people, even if somebody does not want to die, he is going to die. قَهَرَهُمْ بِالْمَوْتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enforced His will upon them. Everybody has to die. Nobody can say that because of my strength, because of my kingship, because of my this and that, I am going to escape the death. No. He has to die because Allah's will is going to supersede. And the ayah of Surah Ghafir, يَوْمَهُمْ بَارِزُونَ لَا يَخْفَى عَلَى اللَّهِ مِنْهُمْ شَيْءٍ لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَحَّارِ. That is very similar to the ayah of Surah Ibrahim. That day, the people would be exposed. Nothing would be hidden out of them and Allah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say, because all the people, that is when the people would die at the doom day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say, لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ. Who got the kingdom today? And then the answer would come from Allah Himself, لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَحَّارِ, for Allah who is dominant. And the ayah of Surah Sad, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا مُنْزِرٌ وَمَا مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ إِلَّا اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَحَّارِ. Say that I am just a warner, and there is no one to be worshipped except Allah, who is one, who is qahhar, who is dominant. And the ayah of Surah Zumar, لَوْ أَرَادَ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَتَّخِذَ وَلَدًا لَاصْطَفَى مِمَّا يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَى سُبْحَانَهُ هُوَ اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَحَّارُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to take His son, He could have taken from His creation whatever He likes. He is glorified. He is Allah. He is Wahid. He is Qahhar. He is dominant. And with this, we come to the end. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.